for some perspective on today's trade. Let's bring in Heist Groenewegen, founder of Silver Arrow Capital Management. He's been bearish, to say the least. He thinks the market will collapse in the first quarter. Collapse.
That's correct.
Even after what we see today, the Fed will come and give us the Bernanke put at any price here. I mean, they're not going to run out of money, right?
Well, if it's a put, how come then that the treasuries have underperformed recently? And I think what's happening, actually, it gives a great exit route to the hedgies and to the Chinese to get out of their bond positions. Because obviously, the money that has been spent hasn't had any impact on the unemployment as we saw today. So there's no traction. So what does it need in order to get, the recovery going?
But it's 1 month report. And there's a lot of people scratching their heads over this one. You know, retail jobs, we lost it. We've seen some strong retail data.
Manufacturing
jobs, we lost.
It'll be revised up 150,000 next
month. We've seen some strong manufacturing. So are you really reading that much into this month?
I have never believed that the economy would recover. Why? Because I think you have a housing market that keeps on collapsing. In October, housing prices were down 14% to the 2003 level. There is no hand holding the market up because people don't have responsibility for their mortgage. Secondly, as a result of that, there is no real consumer confidence because if you have undervalue in your house or negative equity...
But consumers are outspending.
They are. And to be honest, it has surprised me because I don't know where the money is coming from that people are spending.
Right.
I think, what was it, 1.2%? And the third thing I have to say is basically the debt levels are extremely high, and we see also that Europe is collapsing again in a way. I mean, it will go away, and then it comes back even worse.
Hey, Alan Nuckman, we've got you out there in Chicago. You're senior market analyst for Agora Financial. Alan, what do you make of how the market kind of shrugged off the jobs data today?
Yeah, that's what I focus on. I focus on the price action. And the price action, the market's been very resilient. Once again, we're moving forward and things, continue to have strength as far as assets go, equities go, and corporate profits are, still extraordinary.
And it's ironic that this market is rallying on the heels of jobs, but if you look at the numbers, and of course, Heist, you probably would take odds at this having been bearish.
I think, also if you look at the productivity, it did very well for us in the beginning of 2000. Yeah, but now it's going to bite us, I think.
So we maxed it out.
Exactly. So I think you don't get those jobs back. But I would like to get to a point about,
They're just gone.
They're gone. I don't think they will come back because that's the productivity improvement you now see. In the beginning, it helped us because it improved earnings. And now, you lose jobs. Yeah.
Right.
The other thing is, a point that I would like to make is on gold and silver. Gold and silver mining companies have been the best performers since October 2008. They've performed by about 250%. Yeah, compared to gold about 100%, silver 144%, and the Dow only 25%.
By the way, we make the point that you're bearish, but that doesn't mean you've been losing money in the stock market, right? Because you have a precious metals hedge fund.
Yeah, but the relative performance is as such that, why is it that gold and silver perform so well if everything is honky-dory?
No, it's a good question.
So why is it, in your view?
Well, because I think there's a huge shift going on from intangible assets to tangible assets. And from paper money to what we say is real money,
right?
Because it has intrinsic value and as such no counterparty risk. Because I think the next sell-off we're going to get, I think counterparty risk is going to be a huge problem.
And by the way, you don't see another sell-off right away. You
no.
think the market is still going to continue to pulse up through the end of the year into 2011?
That's correct. I think we get an end-year rally, and we will also get a New Year's rally. Because of the Fed.
But if the Fed keeps going for several months, I mean, there seems no signs of stopping at this point. Everybody keeps coming on and talking about $1 trillion worth of assets that we're going to see from the Fed. QE3, QE4, or what have you.
That's true, but at one stage, off is off. I mean, finish is finished. At one stage, people are not going to accept it anymore, and the credibility will be gone. And that's exactly what I think is going to happen.
Alan, let's bring you into this. I mean, is there at some point that you see also the credibility is gone from the Fed, it no longer a supporter for the markets?
Well, when I was young, I was taught don't fight the Fed. And right now, there have been some perception changes that people think interest rates are going to go up. The Fed continues to do this. When will they stop? Who knows? But interest rates, shouldn't go up. And obviously today's numbers, indicate that as well. So interest rates should go back down. What I find most powerful is the fact that all these assets, and as, your guest there has alluded to, that, it all comes back to commodities. And all these other asset classes right now have done very, very well in the face of a strengthening dollar. The dollar's gone up 10%. 10% in the last month or so, and all of these markets have held strong. So just imagine when and if the dollar declines, how that would be supportive of all these other resource assets and really push the markets up as supportive. You're seeing that in crude oil leading the way right now.
Do you see it at all that way, Hayes, or no?
Well, you know, for me, the main thing is, the question is, how come that you have an asset class that doesn't give you any annual return, cost you money, storage money and insurance money, outperforms all the asset classes that give you an annual return? That's the question. That's what you have to think about.
Now, and people have lost faith in paper assets. And so they want to see something like you talked about, something tangible. You know, people, there's a certain, you know, obviously supply and demand, crude oil is going to be used, food's going to be used. These are assets that people are starting to appreciate as a financial class, whereas they didn't before. And, you know, you've seen the GLD, the SLV, the USO. All of these ETFs have done fantastically well because people want to be in something that they understand and they can physically see as opposed to a piece of paper, because a stock is just worth what people think it's worth, whereas other components have real value.
Hey, Alan, it's Dominic here. But if that's the case here, what are we looking at in terms of how do people position portfolios on your side of things? Are people just wholesale moving out of these kind of paper financial assets, stocks and bonds, into commodities and into ETFs? Or how do you do it? How are you advising clients right now then?
Not really, but you can see, like, you know, even some of the industrial stocks that you mentioned earlier, Caterpillar, obviously, look at the businesses they're in. Look at all the oil service stocks. The OSX, oil service sector, is, you know, had a huge run. And if you look at it technically, it looks like it's, you know, poised for another 25% upward move. So those sectors are supporting the stock market in general. If you look at metals, miners, and energies, and you're seeing a lot of these physical goods come from a very, very depressed level, and people are starting to dab in them. If you look at it in dollar terms, the investments in the futures markets, commodity markets, and these ETFs that I mentioned, it's tiny in comparison to mutual funds, but it's growing and you're seeing a bit of a shift. People aren't going to exit one and get another. They're going to have a balance, whereas before people never had any exposure to the commodities assets before, directly anyways.
Guys, let me just ask you, if you were to look at gold versus silver, silver's up more than gold, silver's more industrially used than gold. Could you actually make the argument that there is some legitimate fundamental demand, not just the hard asset demand?
Yeah, at this moment I don't think so. The reason why silver goes up suddenly is because it is always a laggard. And next to that, the silver market is much less deep, of course, than the gold market. So you only need a fraction of the demand for silver in terms of funds coming into the silver market in really to boost the prices. I mean, I think if we could easily go to, you know, $40, $50, the moment you break through
for silver.
The moment you break through the 48, next to that, it's cosmetically very cheap. You know, I mean, an ounce of gold costs you $1,400. You know, silver costs you $29. So if you want to have some support, and that's why they call it also poor man's gold, because it's very easy for people with less income or less wealth to acquire.
And we should make the point, you are more bullish going forward as well on silver than
Correct.
You are on gold.
Correct.
At Silver Arrow Partners.
Absolutely.
Is it any coincidence?
No, you know, the reason I am more bullish on silver is because if I think what I think is going to happen in the markets, and you will need to back up a new monetary system with gold, that gold could be confiscated. So people will then shift to silver.
Oh, wait,
because
that's
a proxy.
Happen?
Why not?
It's happened in the past.
Exactly.
Yeah, no.
Look
I know.
Alan,
you're laughing. Got a few seconds left here.
Yeah, if you look at the all-time highs of gold, if you adjust for inflation, we've got to get to $2,200. So, yes, we've had a huge incline, and there's a lot more risk up here, but there's still more upside just to reach those highs from 1980. And looking for assets in general, 335, we're not even there for the halfway point in the CRB.
All right, we got to run. Hey, Alan Heiss, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.